Howdy, I'm Bob Behnken, spacewalker on STS-130, and you're watching NASA TV.
Good morning to you today, Kay.
Good morning, Houston, and also a special good morning and big thanks to my sister Becky, as we're having a beautiful day up here, getting ready to install Node 3 and begin EVA number one.
While we were away for a moment ago, the repressurization of the space station's airlock commenced and was completed. And just a moment ago, 4:17 this afternoon, Station Commander Jeff Williams reported that the airlock hatch is open. And that allows spacewalkers Bob Behnken and Nick Patrick, who are now on oxygen masks, which have long hoses on them, to re-enter the station and begin their hygiene break. They'll be heading back into the airlock, accompanied by Williams, Shuttle Commander George Zamka, and Flight Engineer T.J. Creamer to continue preparations for tonight's spacewalk. In our current shot, that's Nick Patrick in the lower left and Bob Behnken in the lower right. Each of them next to their spacesuits.
And Houston Station, space to ground two, we're closing the hatch at this time.
Houston copies, and we are ready.
Houston time this afternoon. The hatch to the Quest airlock being closed. With spacewalkers Bob Behnken and Nick Patrick inside, now accompanied by Station Commander Jeff Williams, Shuttle Commander George Zamka.
This is a view inside the International Space Station. Astronauts Terry Virts and Kay Heyer are located at the robotics workstation to operate Canadarm2. Virts called down a moment ago, indicating that they are getting into the procedure to grapple Tranquility in Endeavour's cargo bay right on schedule. These are views from cameras on the outside of the International Space Station, watching the space station robotic arm getting poised to latch on to Tranquility.
I could take the RMS elbow to the right a little bit.
Understand, RMS elbow to the right. Put that in work.
Shuttle astronauts Terry Virts and Kay Heyer are operating Canadarm2 for the grapple of Tranquility in preparation for its installation on the International Space Station. The space station's robotic arm, Canadarm2, is moving in ever so slowly to latch on to Tranquility. The end of the arm is passing over the grapple fixture, getting close to the latching point where snares within the end effector will close around the pin. The spacewalkers are getting ready to open the airlock hatch and then turn their suits on to battery power to start tonight's spacewalk. Astronaut Bob Behnken is the first to exit the station's Quest airlock.
Okay, Steve, I can verify that my tether is closed and locked on the app.
As you come out, you can think about closing the thermal cover once you're out.
Okay.
Astronaut Nicholas Patrick is now making his way out of the Quest airlock. Have a couple more setup steps here outside the Quest airlock, and then we'll make their way to Endeavour's cargo bay. This is a view from the helmet camera on astronaut Nicholas Patrick's spacesuit.
Steve, I'm at the Note 3 LTA.
The power for the heaters on Tranquility has been inhibited, and the heaters have been deactivated in preparation for these cables to be removed. This is a view of astronaut Bob Behnken working also on the Tranquility module or node. He is removing some covers on the port that will be installed on the station. Those covers have been protecting the docking ring.
Okay, Steve, I am ready for covers 4 and 5.
There are 8 covers that he will retrieve and stow in trash bags to bring back inside.
Hey, Bob, once you get that back in place on your left hip there, you've got to go to head back towards the ODS.
Copy that, Steve.
Nick, I'm ready for your tether swap report.
Thanks, Steve. My analog safety tether load alleviator is on my left bearing, closed and locked.
Very nice, Nick. With that, you've got to go to head on back to the airlock. It should be a scenic route. You've got sunset in about 7 minutes.
I see that. Thank you. Where are we, if I may ask? I would like a hand-drawn number, please, for the avionics bag stow.
Airlock handrail, 555.
555, yep,
you're over the end of the hatch.
Say again?
Yeah, you know where it is.
Yep, I'm right there. Okay, Steve, there are now 2 spare safety tethers on the PCBM trash bag.
Copy, Bob.
I'm looking at lab handrail 208. I think it's one of my 208 Zenith, maybe?
It is indeed. 208 Zenith, as you're looking at the MLI bag, will be the upper right strap. Make sure the hinge is towards your left or forward.
Okay, let me reorient that. Okay, Steve, I am on the FCU, and I do have an increasing O2P.
Thank you, Bob. Copy, Houston.
Houston copies.
The bag is tethered to 208 Zenith.
OK, Okay, do you want to go left or do you want to go towards your feet?
Is it 208 Zenith, is that correct?
It is 208 Zenith.
Okay. The next one is 220 Nader, correct?
220 Nader, towards your feet on the right side.
I'll go in that direction.
Confirm hinge forward, please.
I can't see the hinge side, but what I have in front of me is the side with two tethers, which I believe is the non-hinge side. I'm looking at the back of the bag. It should be double tethered, you're saying?
It is double tethered when I configure the bag.
Okay, so I'm going to remove one of those tethers, if you're all okay with that. 220 Nader, is that correct?
That's correct, 220 Nader.
Thank you.
And that the avionics trash bag and the other it does end up on your mini workstation eventually.
Roger that.
Houston Endeavor for EVA, not sure if you got my last question.
Negative, say again, Steve Ray.
We're discussing which way you would like Nick to translate to the app end cone of node 1. Do you want him to stay on the Nader port side, or do you want to have him come back around to the airlock? This is for safety tether routing, of course.
Spacewalker Nicholas Patrick has removed the second set of fasteners holding the stowage platform in place.
Thanks, Bob.
And the crew members will work on moving it to its storage position on a tray on the port side of the truss structure.
We'll have control of the OTP by the scoop.
There just for a second.
I'm holding it, and I'm still registered, of course.
Okay, can you lower your right arm?
How's that?
Continue. Okay, I've got the OTP.
Okay, you have it.
This is Mission Control Houston continuing to watch the space station robotic arm, Canadarm 2, maneuver the Tranquility node ever so slowly through a staged fashion or procedure for its installation on the International Space Station. Astronauts Terry Virts and Kay Heyer are at the controls of Canadarm 2 from a robotics workstation inside the station's Destiny Laboratory.
Let me keep this down here for you, Bob. I have the square grid in my hands.
Okay. You've got control of the OTP. I'm going to
stand by one while I just reorient my grip. You ready?
I am ready.
Okay, I'm reoriented.
Okay. I'm going to, you've got positive control of the OTP. I'm going to release the PRT.
I have control.
saying is, you know, the big picture is square group scoop comes off, position the OTP, and install the hinge pin around the HAB handrail.
Okay, it's going to have to come towards you, Nick. Okay. That might just be... There we go. How's that? I've got a hold of it, Nick. Do you need to reorient?
No, I'm good.
Okay. And I'm ready.
Astronaut Bob Behnken is using the pistol grip tool to engage one hinge pin in the tool platform to stow it in place. Astronaut Nicholas Patrick is finishing the reconfiguration of the area where the crew members were working on the tool platform, and astronaut Bob Behnken is complete with his tasks there and is ready to head back to the airlock, where both crew members will meet up again to stow some of the bags or equipment they've been using.
Once you get to the airlock, Bob, I'll take a glove inspection from you.
OTP bag, do you have a preferred location here at the airlock?
Let's add that to the list of things that Houston's going to suggest when they come back to us.
Houston, the Tranquility node is being moved into the ready-to-latch position.
Okay, Steve, I'm at handrail.
Canadarm2, the space station's robotic arm is moving Tranquility as it is being operated by astronauts Terry Burtz and Kay Heyer. It will move into this contact point on Unity, connecting the two ports, and then there will be two procedures of a two-staged fashion of capture latches being engaged to secure Tranquility in place.
And Houston, you know I'll be looking forward to your next words.
Roger.
Node 3 is moving in.
Bob, if you have a moment to spare.
Thank you.
If you could go around the other side and look up the other one for me, then I don't have to leave it on one tether or do anything complicated.
Okay, and so that's going to be on this side where I'm at, correct?
And it'll be on the other side. Stand by.
Handrail 245.
Yeah, no, you're right. Let me pass it to you.
Okay, just,
and this is a 245 and adjustable bulb, which I'm about to give you. Okay.
I'll take it from you.
Thank you.
And Steve, just to verify which end of 245.
That's true, it's the aft end of 245 and 244.
Okay, it's the bag down to 245 aft.
Okay, it's got two feathers. I'm releasing the ret from my BRT.
Cabinet. How loose is that ret?
It's completely extended. The adjustable over here is completely extended, Bob.
Okay.
Stand by while I just release my ret.
And Bob, if your camera is handy, sunrise is in about 5 minutes. It shows just off your left shoulder there, your left hip.
I do see it. It looks really good. Nice and smooth coming in there. I'm not sure it's moving much right now, but I'd have to get a slightly different vantage to verify that. So I could go and get in position.
As you can see from this view, astronaut Bob Behnken is nearby watching the Tranquility node move into position on the Unity node.
Is yours fixed down, Bob?
It's only fixed down.
Okay, if it's attached, I'm going to take mine off for a second and turn it to get one twist out. You ready?
Okay, go ahead.
That's done. It's reattached. I'm going to cinch mine halfway.
Ethan, can we spare three or four minutes for Bob to take photos?
I think we can spare a few more than three or four minutes, so just enjoy the view and take some photos.
Roger that.
And Steve, I know it's early, but with the pausing and such, I would like to ask for a consumables status check here. I know we're probably going to get ahead of even more as we stand by in the upcoming minutes, but just to see where we're at.
Yeah, so would I.
Copy. We're thinking the same thing, and we're pulling that together.
Bob, if you could, do you want to pull on your adjustable a bit and take some slack out of your end while we wait?
Okay, I've got all the slack out of my end.
Okay, I have all the slack out of my end now.
Okay.
Steve, while we're waiting, I can tell you that the two faces of the bag facing me have no gaps. The jumpers are hidden behind the bag.
Copy. Great job.
I guess, Nick, what I'd like to do is this seems a little bit insecure to me.
Okay.
So if you leave yours end tethered.
I will do that.
Okay, what I'm going to do is move mine to the forward end of 245. And if you could move yours when we get to that point to the handrail just behind it.
Sorry, just
aft of it.
Aft of it.
Okay, so I'm going to relocate mine.
Look at that.
It should just make the bag a little more diagonal on here, but we'll be able to cinch it down a little bit better.
Okay.
Okay, I am relocated. You have a go to relocate your end.
Relocating my end. So to the, just a few inches here, to the aft end. You want me to go to the aft end of the next handrail, way down there.
The forward end of the next handrail.
In the procedure to secure Tranquility in place, the crew will move into the first stage capture. There are two stages of capturing the latches and securing the module in place.
Hey, 101 was pretty tough to remove there, Steve.
Yeah, we were one.
The jack and the pin size, the plug size are three or four. The pins are full straight at the EMI band. Looks good.
Sounds good, Nick. Just before you made it, can you tell me you got that dust cap on the P1 out of your trash bag?
I don't yet. I'd like to make this one first to keep it stable and then go for that dust cap if that's all right.
That's fine, as long as we don't forget it.
Thank you. Good call.
Thank you, Nick. Looks very nice to me. see what Houston says.
Stevie Ray, we're good with Nick's configuration.
Great. Thanks for the quick response there, Hal and the team. Okay, Nick, if you would let Bob get to work there. Take a breather, if you would. Think about MLI vice relocating the jumper bag.
Roger that. And my
yeah, that was Bob that said that, right?
It was.
Thank you.
And there is really no buckle to speak of on the Charlie. It's just right at the 619 handrail, but it does look good for the turn test.
Station Capcom, Helen Getzelman talking with Mission Specialist Bob Benkin, who you can see here through Mission Specialist Nick Patrick's helmet camera. Patrick taking a
Bob,
photo of Benkin while Benkin answers some questions for the ground about his communication.
Roger.
Dan Houston, Endeavor for EVA, thinking about starting cleanup for EV2, and was wondering if you're ready for that.
Houston's ready. Good plan.
Great, thank you.
Both spacewalkers in view here on the newly installed Tranquility module. Mission Specialist Bob Benkin at the very top of the screen.
We'll go ahead and get Nick's fuel inventory.
I am.
Very good. I've got you on camera.
And Nicholas Patrick towards the center of the screen on the right side of Tranquility.
Just give me a second there, Steve.
Sorry.
Hey, Steve, I'm just going to get a end effector on here. And I'm going to switch to alt radio.
Copy.
And Steve, comm check on the alt radio.
You are loud and clear. It sounds identical as you did before.
Okay, and your volume sounds still kind of weak, similar, exactly the same as it was before, and I do have the alt radio at 6.
If you so, be ready for that. If so, we'll go relay comm with Bob.
Roger that.
Now 6 hours and 20 minutes into today's 6.5 hour long spacewalk.
Just about the place where we say divers take the suited subject to the surface.
And it marked the fourth spacewalk for Bob Benkin. His total is now 25 hours and 51 minutes. And the first for Nicholas Patrick, who, of course, has 6 hours and 32 minutes now under his belt. Mission Specialist Bob Benkin there, and just a moment ago, Nicholas Patrick getting out of their spacesuits following today's spacewalk.
Endeavor Houston, air to ground 2 for Terry.
Go ahead, Shane.
Hey, Terry, sorry you got cut out there with some RadiCom, but you called about the CWCs.
Yeah, I purged the water transfer line. Is that all you wanted me to do today? The first step had me get everything out, but I didn't do that. I think he just wanted me to purge the line. you know when our first CWC fill is?